RACERRRZ Studios presents. Have you ever been working on a project and noticed that your GPU memory might just be inefficient and then this happens? Okay, that's not ideal. Let me show you another example. So maybe we're working away on a 3D model here. That's looking really good, nice AI, and let's do a test run. What does it look like? Critical error, oh dear. It's okay, let's play some Cyberpunk. Surely this will work just fine. Take a bit of a break from the hard work there, and oh, blue screen, that's terrible. Okay, never mind, we'll try a little bit of DaVinci Resolve. This should work, no troubles. We'll quickly export this video. That's looking good, and no error. That's okay, we'll play a bit of Forza. Installing RACERRRZ. Okay, there he is, let's do this. Low system memory, again. Oh, this is getting frustrating. Does your search history look something like this? Insufficient virtual memory on your GPU. Well, here's one solution. Oh, look at this, RTX 3090 Ti. That first link looks really good. ZOTAC, it fits. No way, let's order one. Oh, that was quick. Hey there, this is RACERRRZ Studios.
Hello.
That was really quick. There it is, the ZOTAC RTX 3090 Ti. AMP HOLO EXTREME, and that is our machine of interest, the HP Z840. The question we have is, does this GPU fit in this particular machine? Well, I can tell you right now it does, because you're going to find out very shortly how to do it. That's right, we're going to go through. Let's quickly get the covers off. Beautiful, beautiful. Check out those Z coolers. They're still working incredibly well. Oh, is that a bit of dust there? That's quite a bit of dust. Okay, we may have to work on some de-dusting. That's not healthy for this machine. So dust plus a bit of humidity can cause shorts, so we'll definitely have to sort that out while we're here. But quick overview of the machine. We have got a tremendous amount of RAM there, 256 gigabytes of DDR4 ECC memory. We do have a RTX 3080. We have the ASUS Gen 4 NVMe adapter and a few other PCIe add-ons, shall we say. But right now we're here for one thing and one thing only, to replace what is an incredible GPU with an even more incredible GPU. Come along on this journey, I'll be sure to explain the process, and you already know what the problem was, virtual memory. So let's have a look at this. Now it's really sad here because that is a RTX 3080, and I don't think we need to replace this because this is perfectly fine. It's okay, we'll put the cover back. But that's why there are lots of errors. Productivity is being able to do things that you were never able to do before. Check those famous quotes, very, very powerful. Okay, let's do this. How do we install what is arguably the biggest possible graphics card that you can install in this particular machine? Well, let me take you through the tour. First step here is checking that the power's off. You should probably do this before you start. So you just hold the power button for a couple of seconds on these machines, it drains any excess power, and then you're in the clear. So these are our 6-pin to 8-pin GPU power adapters. Very, very capable, allowing us to run our modern GPUs. There are 6-pin connectors in your Z840, 3 in particular. The net wattage on those is about 550 between the 3, so we do have enough for these modern GPUs. Unless you need 4, that could be problematic. Okay, easy does it on the removal. Now you'll notice the top slot here on our PCI bays is going to be the boot drive. That is an NVMe enclosure. Check out one of my related videos to see how to fit your NVMe. We also did a modification on there. Oh, bit of paper there, that's not good. I assume they came off the GPU. And let's see if we can get this GPU out. Now, don't worry, the 3080 here will live on in another machine and will continue to help produce excellent footage. We'll keep an eye out for a future video on how we make use of this card as well. But for now, let's gently remove this. You'll notice these cards only barely fit within this machine. But there it is, 3080, it's served me really well. We've produced lots and lots of content using this machine, but it has a new home now. We do need to get it there. Let's do a little bit of B-roll, the final outtake here. So the 3080 STRIX 12 gigabyte model, it is an incredible GPU. But we're going to go through and do a little bit of fine tuning here to figure out why would you want to upgrade from this, and who would want to more dust. Wow, that's really dusty. This has not been in there that long. That's incredible. It's okay, we'll do some de-dusting later. Stay tuned for that. But in the meantime, let's continue our process. So one of the major problems with this particular installation, let me take you for a closer look, is hard drive fans. So we do need to deal with this particular, should we say, fan module, because our new GPU will not clear this module. Now, if you're observant, you're going to notice that's going to lead us to a bit of a problem. How on earth are we going to keep our hard drives and presumably GPU cool if we're removing two very, very important fans, not to mention the error codes that this workstation's going to have as a result? Wait, is that dust? Whoa, is that? Oh my goodness, look how dusty that is. That's terrible. This better not be my machine. I cannot believe it. It's okay, regular de-dusting is a must. These modern systems pull a lot of air. I'll give you a sneak preview. We'll do this later. The top secret de-dusting method. That is an air compressor that you're hearing, but we'll do more on that later. Stay tuned. Talking about later, somewhere in this video is a top secret item. If you can locate it, you'll gain access to a bonus video. But only those who are really dedicated will get to see it. Let's see if anyone can find it. It will remain a top secret private video. Let's see if you can track it down. Now here it is, the ZOTAC AMP HOLO EXTREME. Very, very capable GPU. The styling on this is incredible, but it is arguably, I think, the biggest RTX 3090 Ti on the market. And let's check the balance here, very important on your GPU. That's excellent balance. I would expect nothing less from ZOTAC. So awesome, it makes for good B-roll shots. Now, quick peel. This is bound to be cinematic. They're always great. That's some pure ASMR right there. So our ZOTAC is fired up and ready. It's gonna help us create incredible footage. We will cover a little bit later on as to why this upgrade is something that you may want to consider, particularly if you have a HP Z840 workstation or any other machine. Oh, nice, we got four ports there, three DisplayPort and one HDMI 2.1, the DisplayPorts being 1.4A form factor. And behind this little sticker is arguably one of the most, should we say, infamous features of these modern GPUs, the 12-pin connector. Let's do a quick peel on this and see what's under the covers. Okay, that was anticlimactic, but there it is. That's our 12-pin connector. Now, the backplate on this particular GPU is absolutely a work of art. We do need to do some B-roll shots here. The upper cover is absolutely glorious as well. Very, very nice finish there on the AMP HOLO. And we do have some incredible coolers there. Three fans with immense power, being able to retain excellent thermal control over this rather large GPU. That's the whole point of the 3090, one of the main benefits. Excellent thermal control, particularly, sorry, that's my bicep taking up a lot of the room there. It's okay, let's quickly show you how to deal with dust. Should we say the racer's way? That's right, this is the Z840 de-dusting extreme edition, quite appropriate to the ZOTAC there. You will not see this on other hardware channels. What are we using? Well, that is an air compressor plus a valve. That's right, we can adjust the pressure, and we're using a rather large gauge nozzle here so that we can very effectively clean our machine. Now, lots of little details here that are important. You'll notice I've got a tank. There's no paint in there, not that I'm aware of. Oh dear, is that paint? But spelling something, is that subscribe? Ah, good idea. You guys should absolutely consider subscribing if you haven't already. But nonetheless, we are currently de-dusting this machine. Now, the pressure is important. You do want to turn this down ever so slightly because you can do damage, particularly on those metal fins. Oh, whoa, is that all CGI or is that actual dust? No, that's actual dust. Wow, that is really dusty. Now, you could do alternative methods here. One of the go-to methods is, of course, being able to use your can of air, but those cans just don't do the job. You'll see why, just from the sheer volume of dust that is built up on these CPUs. Particularly that cooler, that is just incredible. That entire fan module is incredible. Okay, let's get this back in. Absolutely consider de-dusting your machine. I'm going to recommend every 6 months if you've got a high-performance GPU, but for now, this is our star of today's session, the NOCTUA. Really, really small form factor, 92 mm fan with a 4-pin plug. That's a standout feature because these workstations require this particular feature. So premium fan, absolutely no doubt. 14 mm low-profile design. More dust back there, that's incredible. So why these fans? Why are they a must? Well, right now, according to my measurements, they are the precise fit to replace the existing fan module, but they're also low profile, meaning we're going to have enough room to clear our GPU, or at least that is my theory. We will test that out soon. Check there. Oh my, look at this dust. That is so dusty. So very important, make sure to de-dust these frequently. Now, while I try to install these fans, a couple of key notes here. So one of the key things is to check the direction of airflow on these, and there are arrows designated on the edges of your fans. Now, you'll notice they're the same size as the existing fans. That's an important property to match, but the only difference there being the overall thickness is slightly thinner. 14 mil, excellent. Now, by my measurements, these are the precise fit for our job. Now, the challenge is ensuring that we do not have any material or cables that are pulled into these fans. Keep in mind, they will be spinning at quite a high RPM, although I do believe these are low RPM, high current flow fans, so they do a pretty good job keeping our machine nice and cool. But very important detail here, let me take you in for a closer look. You'll notice, with our GPU fitted of course, the clearance is incredible. Look at that. Not to mention the clearance for the ZOTAC, which literally does not clear. I think that's an exact fit. But our fans clear perfectly as well, which means they will rotate without any problems. The only challenge is going to be to keep cables out, and to solve that problem, we're going to use cable ties, but a cable management. It's not featured heavily on the channel, but I promise we will do some cable ties. Now for now, let's get you a better view over here. I say better, it's not much better, but you get the idea. Key thing here is we want to try and cable manage, and we also want to try and secure these. So the best method I have for now is using cable ties. Now forgive me, I know that's not the ideal. You probably want to use something. Oh wow, what is this? That looks like some damage. In fact, that is exposed metal on a hard drive connector. So you want to keep an eye out for these, particularly with these modern GPUs. They place a lot of added strain on some of these cables, and that particular one is now a bit of a spark risk. We will replace it. Now, managed to secure all the corners. It's quite difficult to secure without obscuring your hard drive, so keep that in mind. But for now, the most exciting part. Let's fit the ZOTAC and see if this actually slots in. So Fitment's exact, I'm not joking, it is an exact fit. There is a little bit of clearance underneath the hard drive bay, but that GPU right now is connecting slightly, but it is an absolute perfect fit. So let's quickly power this up. To be able to power this GPU, you must have these 6-pin to 8-pin adapters. Now, I do query these a little bit because quality is of paramount importance. Particularly with all the news about power connectors melting and burning up, we definitely don't want that in a machine that I need to be really reliable. It's running for several hours and I'm not always there to take care of it, so it does need to be pretty self-sufficient. Now let's check out this 12-pin connector. So very infamous and a lot of limelight for this particular connector because there's been quite a few that have burnt up. I say quite a few, not that many, but enough to be a cause for concern. Now, looking at some of the reports, generally it appears, according to Gamers Nexus in particular, that it's primarily user error, so we've got to be careful on these. There are a few other design quirks that have come out, and I think the most important one here is making sure that it is fully inserted. So absolute heads up there, check out Gamers Nexus video, which is absolutely incredible, outlining the scientific properties of these particular plugs. Okay, so very important point here, you won't see this anywhere else, make sure you fit this plug the right way around. They only go one way around. That was not the right way. Here we go. Okay, so that's in, but let's take a closer look. So very important here to check for the click. Sorry, it's a little blurry, but as soon as you have it fully inserted, you're good to go. So that wasn't too difficult. But next step here are these 6-pin to 8-pin adapters. We do want these to be secure, listen for the click, but as far as I can tell, that's now connected and powered. There are a few other quirks to be aware of. The first one is clearance. But there is another issue aside from clearance, but check out the clearance. That NVMe adapter currently does not fit. I had to remove the plate and it's slightly skewed because the back plate's so large. The CPU fan barely gets any air, and there's one other problem which you may or may not have spotted already. If you've got a good eye, you might have seen it already. Allow me to show you. Are you ready? Look at that problem. That's right, that 12-pin to 8-pin to 6-pin connector is way too large. Now you could force your cover back on, but given the bad press I'm not prepared to do that. I'm just going to leave the cover open for now. I need to find a solution for that. But in the meantime, we can confirm the ZOTAC 3090 Ti does fit in the HP Z840 workstation. Definitely scope out this card if you're keen for a card that can do immense, immense things on your workstation. Very, very powerful, 24 gig of VRAM. And we're going to scope out some more of these features very shortly. Now, quick bonus footage for a upcoming video. It's not enough. I needed more PCI ports. The only way I could gain access was to use what I'm going to call a bit of a GPU hack. No one, as far as I know, has done this. This will be the first time anyone has attempted this. We're going to put in two adapters underneath our GPU to include 10 gigabit Ethernet, as well as the 3090. So that cable is going to plug in underneath. But for now, let's go for some really, really cool tests. What use is it to install a big GPU if we're not able to do some testing? So we're going to go for a couple of tests. First one is Time Spy. That's right, 3D Mark. We're going to compare the 3080, which we have replaced, 12 gigabyte model with the 3090 Ti, 24 gigabyte. Now, according to most posts online, these are actually really similar. You'll notice here, generally, that 3080 is actually outperforming the 3090 Ti, which is a little strange, but apparently that's a thing. And notice the power draw is meant to be much higher on the 3090. We do have a slight difference on display ports. 3080 actually had an extra HDMI, which is really awesome, but that was the STRIX overclock model. Really, really awesome 3080. But in terms of our visual feedback here, we're seeing almost identical performance. Key thing, key notes here, the 3080 is perfect for gaming, but the 3090 presents lots of benefits for people who are a bit more creative, maybe creating video and or doing any sort of data science. Really, really handy. Check out that score. How's the 3080 score higher? I have no idea, but nonetheless, key differences. 24 gig of VRAM is the main focus here. We do have slightly faster memory as well. But let's go for another test. Data. Forza Horizon 5, check out a related video, but for now you can check out the strain on the CPU. Both GPUs place similar strain on the CPU, so we can confirm the CPUs are not bottlenecking. Now, GPU power use, interestingly, the 3080 actually used more power, which is interesting, but that's because the settings in Forza, at least, were for the 3080. Now, next key thing here is memory use. Not really expecting a difference there. If there is a difference, it's because there was more software in the background, but quite a lot of memory there, including for the GPU, pushing around 12 gigabyte for Forza. Next one, power usage. Check those out. Pause on the data if you want to have a closer look, but really just checking to see what sort of power draw we're using on our two cards and if they're similar. And next one here is temperatures. You will notice a difference in NVMe temperature because I made an extra modification, but more on that in a future video. But otherwise, we're seeing some really interesting temperatures. So massive, massive reduction in thermals on the 3090 Ti, and that's a direct result of that cooler. So quick conclusions, 3080 is a solid performer, but the 3090 runs cooler, tends to use more power, although less power at the same time. It's really confusing. Time Spy, quick data as well. Let's have a look. So CPU clock speeds, generally that 3080 actually scores higher, and the CPU strain is very similar. Now, I do think the recording was a bit slow here on the 3080's data log, but nonetheless, you can see both used immense amount of power, but the 3080 actually used more power. Very confused. Definitely got the data right. Next one, we had memory use, both very similar, although slightly higher on our 3090 there. For the next data set, we also had lots and lots of power draw measurements. Collectively, the machine does draw more power for the 3090, about a 100 watt increase over the whole machine, maybe 650 over 750 watt. And for the last one there, temperatures. So temperatures were good, generally didn't see too big of a difference. NVMe temperatures are the result of the modification to my hard drive, or NVMe 970 Evo. And we also had a very solid reduction in temperature for the GPU, but you would have expected that given the size of the cooler. Check out that temperature, around 45 degrees for the GPU itself. The hotspot temperature mimicked the memory junction, so we'll keep an eye on that plug. That might be the hottest point. But for now, 3080, solid for gaming. 3090, perfect for creators, especially if you're creatively inclined. So hopefully you enjoyed that content. Stay tuned for future videos. Hopefully you found the secret. I'll see you in the next one.